Started. What's been the highlight so far for everybody? Don't be shy.
Zach.
Good answer.
Eliza.
Great answer. Louisa. Chelsea. Everybody. Okay. All right. Here are the men of Con again. Sit wherever you like. Hi guys.
Flying off that chair.
What's up?
I know. Do you want the small chair you can sit in front?
No.
Alright. Do it.
Hi guys.
Did we miss our cue?
You did, but that's not shocking. No, it's Connie Eden. And then there's Chris down by himself.
Hello.
Hello. Is it us you're looking for? Would you like to come over or?
I just did mine, so I'll let them.
But they were crazy. They went the throw you the mic. It's a whole thing. So one of the things that we actually talked about with Chris's panel is male friendship on this show. I mean, they had a lot of very interesting, complicated relationships. I'd say Miller and Bellamy is one that I wish they'd explored more and you had more time with. You had your ups and downs, but did you have, when you read each script or each call sheet, were you like excited when there were certain people that you were going to be paired with that you don't normally always work with?
I think on the show they always tried to find different couplets and you know trios to go out and do certain things. But I know that that whenever I got to work with Jared or Zach, like we'd always try and really nail those stuff. With me and Tom, not so much. No, but like we definitely tried to build that into it all, especially with Miller. Like if it wasn't written, like you know, like Monty and Bellamy were written. Whereas things like with Miller and Bellamy, we definitely tried to amplify those scenes to kind of really build that friendship. And so when it wasn't written and when they kind of just glazed over, it was always a little bit disappointing, I think. I think there was one bit where you came out of the bunker and you and I had to fight for that moment to like give each other a hug, whatever. You don't remember.
Yeah, I do. And there was a scene that was left towards the last one.
Yeah.
That we shot that didn't happen.
Yeah,
tell us.
Yeah. It was a nice scene.
Yeah, that's true, actually.
But yeah, to Bob's point, I always thought of Miller as being Bellamy's best friends, if not best friend, at least in his view. That's how I tried to portray it.
Yeah, you're my best friend.
No, you were my best friend.
Aww.
You had other friends. You were my best friend.
Yeah. And Zach, what's interesting is if you look back at all of Rowan's time, most of his friends mostly were women, I would say.
Oddly, he had a lot of female friends.
Yeah.
I thought that it was all platonic, like just friends. Which is weird, because actually I have a lot of female friends.
Platonic?
Yeah, platonic. Like I like all people. But we also, I mean, we kind of broed out a little bit a couple times.
Yeah, we definitely did. We had like that kind of cool bit where the car chase scene.
Yeah.
That was quite fun.
Yes.
Yeah, there was a car chase.
The Rover chase, really.
Yeah, we had a car chase. Tom's like, what? What happened?
Yeah, they had me jump out of the top of the Rover onto the truck. In fact, I met Jared for the first time inside the Rover. I met you in the back of the Rover.
Yeah.
Thomas, don't feel bad. In the last panel, Chelsea literally found out that Bellamy died and she freaked out. Chelsea had not seen it, had not heard,
Bellamy
freaked
what?
Out and had a therapist. It's amazing how many people came up at the party last night and said, I didn't watch past that. They didn't watch the finale after yours, so. They have a headcanon about
show of hands,
that.
Show of hands.
Who didn't watch the actual final episode of the show?
Wow.
That's some Team Bellamy right there.
All right.
Shit, I watched it. Okay. Yeah. So, Bob, I know it's controversial, but, you know, it's kind of an elephant in the room. May I ask, what was your response? Because Chris said he was with you eating pizza when you found out. That you read on your phone, you read your script and found out that your character was going to be no longer.
Well, I mean, I did ask for time off.
Yes.
Yeah. So I think, you know, I was having, you know, I was battling quite hard with my mental health. So I knew that my role would be truncated. When I found out, I started looking at flights back to Los Angeles. That's about it. I mean, it took a little bit of time and to kind of process it all, but at the end of the day, for me personally, it was the right thing. And I'm quite grateful that I did get that time off. You know, I felt it was interesting because I saw how the fandom felt about it. And I took a lot of that guilt on myself, going, oh, you know, I didn't fulfill Bellamy's story the way that he probably would have played it out. But as time has passed, I've gone, you know what, it was the right, absolute right thing for me to do. And, you know, personally, I as much as I love season 6 and 7, I really felt like it was a real, we kind of finished up really around season 5. I thought that was a wonderful ending.
Hey, look,
thank you. But yeah, it was, I mean, I haven't really spoken about it that much publicly, but yeah, it was the right decision for me. And yes, I'm grateful that I was allowed that, you know, they gave me the grace of being able to leave the show.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
What would be your favorite season for Bellamy then overall?
Look, it has to be season one. You know, season one I think was the best. Even though it was the biggest kind of arrogant bastard Bellamy, for me as an actor, it was the most fun.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. Thomas, let's talk about your, you know, it's interesting because your character's death really kicked off the Grounder stuff. I mean, you know, the whole, the Mercy Kill situation. Do you remember what it was like to film that, your death episode?
Yeah, I remember Lindsay Morgan was like doing this pretty extreme acting job. Which was like pretty intense. That's the part I remember the most. It was a cold night.
You can see your breath on the screen.
You were like way down there on the pole.
Yeah, I was way down over there and you guys were like way up there, which was like
screaming.
Yeah.
If Finn had lived, what do you think his role would have been with the delinquents and like in the future seasons? Have you watched any of the show?
That's more good question.
I didn't watch any of it.
Okay. So you wouldn't really have any way to answer that question?
Well, no, I couldn't really say.
You didn't even know we had cops.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair.
I mean,
they ate people too.
I found out that they left Earth,
right,
and then went to a different planet, and then went back to the Earth again.
They ate people. It was a whole thing. Yeah, they were in a cannibal season. Zach, for you, you know, badass warrior. You got to do a lot of sort. You know, obviously Black Sails. Zach's been around the block.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Yeah,
He said black friend, black sales.
Wow, okay.
Do you get some work?
You did a lot of physical work and stunt work. Did you do most of your own stunts on this show?
Yeah, most of them. There was a couple times where they had... Yeah, there was some times where basically I always do whatever they'll let me do. And then sometimes they come around and they're like, you're not going to do this.
Right.
We can't kill you today.
I think,
and I'm like, why not?
I think Watch the Thrones is an amazing episode when you fought Lexa in that. What was it like filming that particular scene?
Actually, that was like my first time working with everyone because prior to that, I'd basically just been with Eliza out in like the woods, like dragging her around it's like the day I met like most of the other cast that I hadn't met, and it was like doing a play because it was like everyone was there just watching, like, all right, let's see what this is like when two people just pretend to fight in the middle of a town square. But it was really great. I mean, Alicia, she was a little worried because she had never done that stuff, and you know, like, I think the first, like literally the first take, she like hit me in the back of the head with the sword. And then she was like, and I was like, don't worry, we're gonna probably hit each other a lot. I was like, let's try not to injure each other too much.
And then you met Brenda Strong, you're like, hi, and then bye, like immediately.
Yeah, like
yeah,
literally.
Your mom.
Bye.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, and by the way, her name is Brenda,
yeah,
and my name is Zach, and my mom's name is Brenda, and her son's name is Zach.
That's awesome. How do you feel about the fate in your journey of Rowan? How do you feel like he ended?
I felt like he got so much more than he ever deserved. I mean, he became a king and he sat on the throne and he tried to bring peace amongst warring clans. He did his best to try to save lives and at least allow, you know, one death instead of many. I still to this day, like, I really think that solo gunplay is just a way better way than what we're seeing in our world generally. Like, I'm like, why don't you guys just go handle it? But yeah, I mean, I think I felt really good, and I had a blast, and you know, there's always the could have been, would have been stuff, but honestly, like, I don't know, I had a blast playing him, and as I always say with characters that die, like, there's, you know, every character dies, whether you see that or not, right? Because every person does. But not every character really lives. That's like the Braveheart quote, every man dies. But like when you die and they haven't given you enough to do, that's really sad. But I felt like I had done so much on the show that to complain about anything would have just been, you know.
Fair. And rather than me bore you questions, I'm gonna have everyone line up because there's so many of you, and if you all would like, there's a microphone in the middle, feel free to line up and ask the gentleman any questions. For the remainder of our time, my work is done here.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead. Hey, Blood Raina.
Hi, yes. I was two more area, I forgot what the name was, but during the dark year, if you guys would have chosen that option. I know Monty probably would have found a better option, and I heard his panel, his view on it, so I wanted to hear yours. Would you eat the meat?
Would you eat the people?
Are you asking if we would eat people?
Yeah. Or would I have to behead you?
Everybody goes into cryo sleep, right? And then Monty and Harper, they stewardship.
They stewardship. They have a kid.
60 years.
60 years.
And then Harper dies. And then Monty doesn't want to live without her. So.
I feel like Thomas just Wikipedia'd this during lunch. For sure. Yeah, no problem with it.
No.
It's just meat, right?
Yeah.
Meat is meat, as they say.
Might have to cook it, you know, more meat than the medium rare than usual, you know.
I think Bellamy wouldn't have eaten people. But that's on the caveat that Monty was there with him, because Monty's like the LG expert. Not right, Chris.
You mean plant-based, is what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Great question, thank you.
I know, you guys are just all amazing actors.
Thank you very much.
Miller was eating people.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. We were in a spaceship eating algae.
Yeah. Algae.
Just like you know, like Finn had in the beginning. We were used to it.
It was a soup.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Haley.
Hi, Haley.
I just wanted to say, Bob, it is not your fault Bellamy's ending.
Oh. I think I just have that default setting of taking responsibility.
Yeah, no, I blame someone else for that.
Would you like some tea?
My question.
Look, I know that they had plans for his storyline that season, and it wasn't to, you know, perish the way that he did. It was to kind of lead everyone out of there and all that kind of stuff. But I honestly, even though when I knew that he was going, I was like, well, can't, like, in my head, I was like, can he at least die trying to save Maddie? At least something, you know? To kind of have the character have a meaningful death in that way. So if he did have to go, then I don't think he would have let that happen to Maddie. And even though he was kind of believing in transcendence, I don't think it would have made him, you know, turn so far away from his morals and everything like that to let that happen to Maddie. So
don't think that Clark would have killed him for a book that she did not take.
She didn't take the book, yeah. Yeah, but you know.
Thank you.
We don't write them.
Tori. Hi. A lot of people in this room have probably heard it, but you guys haven't. I just wanted to thank you guys because this show means so much. I had it during my Boston diagnosis in 2014, and it helped me through self-harm and everything. And it helped me get better, and I just wanted to thank you guys so much for that. And then I also had a question for you guys, all of you. What was like the hardest scene, like either emotionally or physically, that you guys had to film in front of this?
Firstly, I just want to say it was so gracious of you to share that with us, and we're so proud of you, so thank you. Wishing you all the well for the rest of your journey. And to the question, the hardest scene for me to shoot was actually the one of the most emotional scenes was the Monty Harper video, Goodbye, in season 5. That was definitely, I think for all of us, like when Chris was there and Chelsea was there, like, you know, every year the show was on a bubble, like we didn't know if we were going to go again, and season 5 definitely felt like the end. And so, yeah, Chris and Chelsea turned up and kind of read off screen, and it was a, like the whole set, like the whole crew was really, like, was like really, like we're all crying and stuff like that, and I remember the first AD going like, come on Bob, go and do something stupid, like, you know, make us laugh. I was like, no, you will cry. but that scene was a particularly hard one, and hard, but...
It wasn't the one where you had to give CPR.
I'll give it a rest. yeah, that scene, that was a tricky one. Yeah, there you go.
Hardest scenes?
Emotionally and physically.
Emotionally and physically. Well, physically, like almost everything I did. So I'll just throw that to the side. Emotionally, I think it was in the lab, and we put poor what's his face in the microwave. That really fucked with me. I was like, this is some like fucking Nazi oven shit. I was like, I don't know about, like, we're supposed to be the good guys? I was like, you don't cook people in the oven. No matter how great or good you think it's going to come from that. So that was, for me, I was just like, kind of disturbed by that emotion. I was like, don't put people in the microwave.
Anyone know the character Obika? Remember that? He's a big giant. Yes. Yeah. So when he was suffering, my character has to run in and like be freaked out over it and try to help the situation. But it was one of the hardest days I've ever had because I remember that?
Yeah, yeah.
And I couldn't get nothing mustered up because I didn't know him. I didn't know Obika. I didn't know how Miller knew Obika. So every time I would try and get something going, I felt very fake. I was like, I gotta do it again. But I just couldn't get it rolling. So that was a frustrating day. And I ran a lot during it, so I guess that's the physical part. But yeah, I didn't know why I was doing any of it, and it was weird.
It was super weird, too, yeah. Like, I remember the director like being like, give us more, and you and I were like, yeah, but he doesn't know this guy. And like, raise it. He's like, yeah, but there's no emotional connection.
Very, very much.
Yeah, yeah. I felt bad for you, because I was like, I'm glad that's not me doing that. Like, and I was like, you can do it, Jared. I was just like,
yeah, thank you for validating it.
This wasn't hard for me, but I just was reminded of when, like, I walked into a jail cell. I was like, your sister's dead. Cry now.
Yeah. And you were like, yeah. It was all like, yeah, but my sister will, you know, blah, blah, blah. And you're like, well, she's dead.
She's dead.
She got kicked off a cliff, but she survived. Yeah.
I felt so bad for you. Like, I was like, and this is like the hardest acting job in the world. I was like, your sister's dead. We're going to take off.
Yeah, it was like a Chekhov play or something,
yeah.
Where I just had to cry and then be laughing the next second. It was wild. But, yeah, but you did remind me of another one. Sorry, I know Chris hasn't answered yet, and Tom just seems a little not too late. But one scene that was really disturbing. One scene that I remember being really difficult, and I don't know if, I think Jared might have been there, Chris might have been there. Actually, I think Chris was there. I'm not laughing at the scene, because it was horrible. But one scene that was really, really horrible was watching Luna basically get waterboarded. And there's no real way that you can stunt fake that. And so it was horrible watching the stunt performer go through that. and listening to that and everything like that, it was like, there's no other way to fake it, really. Especially the way they wanted to shoot it. So that was really disturbing. I remember getting home and being like, that's really effed up. Like, just, yeah. But you were going, Wells was tough for you, was it, Tom?
Yeah, I mean, that was pretty early on there, wasn't it?
What was that, the first episode?
I think it was the third episode.
You need to go back to Wikipedia, Thomas. Chris, did you have an emotional or physical scene?
Sure. In season two of Mount Weather, we're sharing, Miller and Monty are sharing a bed. And there was a moment when Jared placed his hand. They didn't use that thing, hence why I'm with Harper, but. Oh yeah, you're a great beat. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Rachel. It's really good to see all of you guys. I want to congratulate Bob on his baby boy.
Oh, thank you.
And before I ask my question, I just need to hear this in your Bellamy voice. Can you say who we are and who we need to be to survive? Very different things. I just need to hear it.
You need to hear that. Wow, I've done Bellamy for a while.
Who we are and who we need to be to survive. Two very different things.
Oh, nice.
Someone asked my question, so I had to come up with a shitty question on the spot. So, okay, so what are your favorite, couplings on the show or ships?
My favorite was Monty and Harper.
Not Ballard?
What?
Ballard?
Oh, yeah, they're not canon, though, so...
You brought it to real life.
I tell you, I wish Minty happened. I think it could have been special, for sure. But yeah, I like what you and Harper had going on, too.
Zach, Thomas, any favorite couples?
What's the one with Eliza and Alicia?
Clexa.
Yeah, that one.
Pour one out.
Come on, this is it. That's got to be everyone's favorite, no?
Yes. You can have a different opinion, Zach.
You know, honestly, no.
Ballard. Aww. The captain of your ship. Excellent question, thank you.
Also, real quick, Zach, I just want to say I loved you in Shameless.
Naked too.
Yes. Be well, be kind.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, my question is about the dark year. I wanted to know what the cubes were made of, if you know, and what they tasted like.
Yeah, I forget what it actually was, but we were talking about it earlier. It was like a Metamucil. When you see Metamucil and it turns into like the gelatin. So it was a hardened, I'm gonna find out so I can let you know. But then there was like nuts in there and there's all these things to give it like the little, what would be probably involved, whatever, right? Like, but no, it was something that was turned into a jello.
Did it have to be vegan? Was it vegan?
I don't think he was at the time, was he?
He was always flipping and flopping between me and vegan and, you know.
Is that right?
Yeah.
It's Scottish.
They changed it because he wanted to be, because he was at that time.
Eating cubes.
Ironically vegan eating people. Great.
Yeah, it wasn't meat-based or anything. I'm gonna find out for you.
And Bob, I'm really glad that Love Me is getting a season two.
Oh, thank you. Yes.
I was wondering if your character had their own soundtrack, what songs would be on?
Well, if your character had his own soundtrack, what would his soundtrack, what kind of songs would be on him?
Lots of gangster rap, a little bit of country, some classic rock.
Yeah, I like the country rock idea, 70s southern rock, but also the song Voodoo Child by Jimi Hendrix specifically. You want to walk into every room with that song going on, you get, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Voodoo Child, baby.
Chris,
John Mayer? John Mayer?
John Mayer?
Do you know that song, Only Time, by Enya? Yeah. Just that, really.
Chelsea picked Enya, too. Interesting choice. Thomas, what would Finn's soundtrack be?
What's that song?
Bon Jovi, Dead or Alive.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
A whole soundtrack.
One song
soundtrack.
One song soundtrack.
Okay.
Bellamy?
I don't know. Like, I actually think that he'd probably be like an Oasis fan, maybe. Yeah. I'm not too sure. Like, I, you know, I've been asked this before, and I'm always like leaning towards things I like. But I think Bellamy and I don't actually like the same things, so, yeah.
Actually, kind of, in some regards,
smartass. Yeah, I don't know, like, I'd love to think that Bellamy was wholesome, but he really, really loved guns. So, yeah, maybe
Kid Rock?
Yeah, no, Kid Rock. Maybe he's a Gunners fan. Yeah, Guns N' Roses fan.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Kelly. I was wondering what episode took like the longest to film?
Took the longest to film? It was the pilot, surely, took the longest. That was like a month of shooting. But most of our episodes were 7 to 9 days, averaging around 8. I don't know if there was like there were particular episodes that we had to keep coming back to. Like, there were definitely episodes we missed shooting stuff. So like towards the end of the season, it was like, oh, we're shooting bits from episode 5 now and episode 3, you know. So some of them took like long to complete, but to shoot, the pilot always takes the longest because that's when most people are there and have like, you know, the higher ups have opinions on things. I remember one time. Us? No, our opinions don't count. I remember one time, one of the producers was watching me do my whole spiel where it starts raining and going, there's something on his face, we need to get rid of it. And I was like, what, my freckles? Yeah, they're going to have to stay. I remember like hearing them chatting behind the monitor and I'm like, oh no, this is my face, like, sorry. Hey, what are we going to do? Oh, we're going to have to recast that guy.
How long were you hanging upside down in Mount Weather?
Too long, actually. Yeah, I think there was something like, technically I was supposed to be hanging out for no longer than a minute upside down, but I think I got to about 4 minutes in one take. But yeah, that was horrible. Have you guys ever been hung upside down? You were in the last...
In that last movie,
yeah.
We did. It sucks to hang upside down. It's not good. Just try it. If you're flying, it sucks. Your blood goes to your head.
Great question, thank you.
Also, real quick, Christopher, thank you for the Coke earlier. I appreciate it.
Not cocaine, people! Soda! Soda! Chris's side gig.
You're welcome.
It's not Jasper.
It would have been funny if you left it down there. Hi, fellow Zach here. Great name. My question, if you guys could have played any other character on the show, male or female, just based off of, you know, watching their journey and how you would have played out, who would you have played?
Murphy for me.
Everyone. I'll say it.
Finn.
Just a quick 2 seasons and get right out of there.
That guy's gonna be well.
That felt really good for a second when you said that.
Like, I
meant
it. I love the way you played Finn. I thought Finn was cool.
Thomas. Well, I would have liked to have been Elise's character.
I give up. Chris?
Oh, no, I just had a question for Thomas. Where's the girl who is wearing this watch? Somewhere during there, like you were shooting up all the village people.
Not the band.
And one of the, I think it was probably the director, whoever was the director of the episode, was like, came over and like, you're making this face. Like, you do like less teeth. And then I went back and like looked at it, and it's like, he's totally correct. I was like, making this same crazy face that you had teeth crazy.
But that, when you said, I found her, is that right? After you killed everyone, you're like, I found her. I found you.
The person who's wearing the watch. It's like, what?
Right.
Someone pull up Finn's Wikipedia page.
I mean, part of me thinks that I would have probably been best cast as maybe, if I wasn't playing Rowan, maybe as like Octavia. But like, the stretch for me would have been Monty, I think.
Yeah.
If I could pull that off, that would have been a really good actor.
Nice.
Just want to give a shout out to Eli Gore, who played Wells. Yeah. He made room for Miller to even exist, so.
Thank you.
God bless.
Off the rails. Next question.
Hi, Bella Mae. How are you?
I'm good.
I'm your biggest fan, by the way.
Thank you. What's your name?
My name's Tim.
Tim?
I'm Bob. Nice to meet you. So, before I have a question for Bellamy, I gotta tell you guys something. Tomorrow when this is over, and I have the posters behind you because it matches my shirt.
We'll check for you.
Okay. All right. So, Bellamy.
Yes.
Who is your favorite cast member besides Clark in the 100?
The human. You mean character or person or actor? Character or actor?
Character.
Oh, favorite character. Oh, okay, because you know they're all my favorite people. My favorite character.
Yeah.
Outside of Clark. What did you assume? The club would be my favorite character? Anyway. My favorite character is actually Monty Green.
Aww.
Okay.
You know, I have to say, I appreciate, I never told Thomas this, but season one, because I wasn't very fancy, so I didn't get invited to do press or anything. But Finn was everywhere. And they'd always be like, Thomas, who's your favorite character? And he'd always drop Monty. I don't even think he meant it, but I appreciated the lie. Thanks, Thomas.
Thomas, who is Monty still your favorite?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, just check it. Jared?
My favorite character? A lot of respect for Bellamy. Ed Murphy. It's Ed Murphy. It's still Murphy. I just love that dry, whatever his performance was. I literally love what he did. I love what he did.
Remember that one?
Fan of that guy.
Nice. Zach, did you answer?
Yeah, I mean, Murphy probably.
Yeah.
I just, Richard was great. He's
yeah.
A good actor.
You know, I like the way that he was always able to,
you know how he would be like on the ground one second and then like upright? Like, did you ever notice that about him? That guy could really get up.
Great question, thank you.
You're welcome. See you later, Bellamy.
Hey guys.
Hey, Mike.
As actors, are you able to give any feedback or input to the writers? Do they just ignore you?
Well, you can, but they don't have to listen.
And generally, you know, you, I mean, listen, every show is different. I've been on shows which are very collaborative, and I've been on shows where it's like, you missed the and in between the two lines. And they're like, they want the exact words as written and no moving from that. So it really depends. On this show, generally, though, kind of did what they wrote.
Yeah.
They didn't listen to me. That's for damn sure. Right.
Diplomatic answers. Chris?
He's like, nope.
What if we did this? Just say Jax. Just say Jax. That's how it goes. But what about if we did this? Just say Jax.
Great question. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sarah. I told the girls panel this as well, but I just wanted to let you guys know that this show helped me so much through being in the hospital with kidney disease because of, like, all your characters went through so much, and it was really great to be able to, like, watch these characters go through so much while I was also going through a lot. And then I also wanted to ask you guys if you had any advice as far as getting into acting. I've recently done, like, extra work and trying to join the SAG after union. And I was just wondering if you had any ideas about how to move up in the acting industry.
I mean, just like anything, I think it's just about time, put in time, keep doing everything you can do. Usually you don't have a lot of options available to you, but you do them. You essentially do whatever is available to you and continue doing that. If you're really passionate about it over time, you'll make headway. And definitely I suggest unions personally because, you know, kind of need healthcare and stuff like that.
Yeah, but getting into SAG and stuff like that, that took me about 7 years. But glad that I'm in it. That's a whole other kettle of fish. But I mean, I think the most important thing is that you have the passion for it. You want to keep learning and keep pushing yourself and finding those different pockets. Like, there's no set formula as to how all of us guys got here. We can all tell you different stories about our journey into the industry. And that's the one thing that I would say is consistent is that we all have a passion for it and just kept trying and auditioning and failing and but not falling out of love with it. Like, it's one of those things that even if I wanted to walk away, there'd be a part of me that wouldn't let me. So it's, you know, I think it's in you. If it's in you, like, to want to do this, then you just keep working hard. Yeah, but it's a difficult career, and, you know, there's a lot of things that come along with it. We're very lucky to be where we are, and very grateful for that. But, yeah, it's just, yeah, working at it all the time. And
developing very thick skin.
Yeah, and just developing skills, like, whichever, wherever you go, like, you know, like, even doing extra work and just seeing how people operate on set, absorbing as much as you can, being a sponge and then finding what works for you. But yeah, I guess that's, you know, having that passion is the driving force behind that whole thing. Yeah.
That's a great answer.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks, guys.
A great deal of luck and timing, of course.
Yeah, I mean, sure. I would have liked to work more, like, yeah, with Jared. And, yeah, I think that's kind of, like, I had a lot of scenes with Clark and Octavia, and I always really cherished those scenes that I got to have with Murphy and, you know, Miller and anyone kind of outside of that, my sister and Clark. Like, Bellamy was so much defined by that, so I always enjoyed, like, stuff with Rowan. It was a different aspect of Bellamy. So any time that I was out of that trio of Bellamy, Octavia, and Clark, it was always fun. Not that those weren't; they were great fun too. But it was just like always fun to kind of explore different parts of who he was.
Yeah. Talk about Henry and Cusick, or like
What about the guy with Jaha? What about him?
Yeah.
And you know, the thing about the show is also is like there's like these different storylines that eventually would intersect, but stayed independent of one another a lot. So if you were in like the A storyline, B storyline, or whatever, you were kind of like, you know, stuck with like a couple people all the time. You didn't interact with like a whole bunch of the other cast. Yeah. So yeah, there's like a whole bunch of people that worked at the same time as I did that I never worked with at all.
Yeah.
Miller actually fortunately was kind of, as Tom was saying, in and out with a lot of characters, so I kind of did pop in, pop out with a lot of people. I think I got everyone covered. But yeah, more Bellamy would have been great for sure.
Yeah, I mean, kind of in this similar vein, like, he really had scenes with almost, like, always the same people. Like, I remember once we got, me and Monty got to do, like, say, like, one word to each other. Like, I was getting into the room or with him. Like, you know, and I was like, oh, we got to do a scene together for the first time. And, I mean, like, even when I met Jared, right, so we were just, like, pulling out in the car and stuff. So, I mean, I really didn't get to work with most people. There were very few people I got to work with. So, kind of like, everyone I didn't get to work with. But you know how that goes, you just, we don't write it. Yeah.
Chris?
I think we had some of the best black actors in the industry on the show. Edina Porter is fucking phenomenal as Indra. Mike Beach's type was like so good. And say what you want about him, Isaiah Washington is a phenomenal actor. So yeah, it was incredible. I wish I had more scenes with him.
We have time for these last two questions.
Hi. How was it playing your guys' character?
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
How was it playing your guys' character?
How was it playing? I mean, it was, for me, you know, I'm on like some other projects now that are very much based in reality. And to look back on the show and go, you know, I've got to run around and play a space delinquent with a gun and, like, have so much fun. Like, it really is quite an opportunity, and I was so grateful for it. Like, at the time, sometimes you get a bit worn down, might be, like, freezing cold, might be this, that, or the other, but when I look back, I can't be anything other than grateful. Like, Bellamy was an awesome character, and he was pretty kick-ass, so, yeah. It was pretty great.
It was a really good experience. I think I'm more familiar with the genre and a lot of parts of the character than I was at the time. I think if I did it today, well, I mean, that's with anything, but I understand him a lot better now. I was kind of, as I was going, I was putting it together and all that stuff. But I have a vision of him that you're going to do everything. You're going to session or whatever. But It was a good experience. It was a really good experience. Changed my life.
Yeah, I feel pretty much the same. Just awesome. Always, like, every character you get to play is a blessing as an actor. You actually get to play them. But like, I think Roan for me was specifically cool. I think it was like the first role I ever played where like kind of everything I was doing on the show was kind of like specifically written for me to do. So it was like, I always felt like very at home playing him, and like that I didn't have to, you know, go too far away from me to do it.
You look very comfortable with everything.
Yeah, except the cooking the people. That's wrong. I'm sorry. Not to cook those people.
Chris or Monty?
Just piggybacking off what Zach said, yeah, it's like they found you, and so they started writing for you or more in your voice, which helped a lot. So it wasn't, at least for Monty, there wasn't a whole lot to latch on. He like wore orange blankets and like made moonshine, and then eventually they start to three-dimensionalize you as a human and like know what your strengths are and your weaknesses, so you can avoid certain pitfalls. So yeah, it just got better. What's up?
Someone's ringtone. Don't worry. Thomas.
Well, the
character that I played called Finn had like a pretty dramatic arc. And so that was. Well, just, you know, relative to other characters, it was a pretty big shift. And so, like, it's fun to play that kind of thing. It gives you something to do, yeah. Yeah, yeah, in a pretty short amount of time. But yeah, in that way, it was really fun.
Thank you. Last question.
So for your next job, who would be your dream writer or director to work with? Pick anyone.
You go.
I don't have one.
Yeah, I don't know. Like this next project I'm working on, I'm working with some really solid Australian talent, and that's really exciting for me. And doing comedy, I've never done that before, so we'll see if I'm any good. But yeah. I mean, there's so many, you know, you can throw out massive names here and there, and, you know, but...
Christopher Nolan!
Yeah. But, yeah, I think that no matter, like, even on, like, smaller jobs than that, you kind of always find the best in people and the best in that job, and just kind of add more to your, I guess, arsenal of what you can and you, what you can use and what you can learn from. So it would be great to go in with, like, a really renowned writer or director, but... also, I reckon it'd be quite intimidating as well at the same time. But anyway.
Mel Gibson or Spike Lee. Yeah. Either one of those would be cool.
Mel Gibson.
Hell of a talent.
You got any ideas? Who are you going to work with? Who do you want to work with?
I was thinking more about like what other kind of types of things to make. Like you've probably worked on like video game stuff.
Yeah.
I think that'd be probably pretty fun. I've never done like full body motion capture.
Oh yeah, that stuff is like fun the first hour.
That's part of it too. It's like what one thing about like working as an actor is you get to learn all sorts of new stuff, obviously. And so that's like that's what I like about it. It's like job you learn all the kinds of new things.
Yeah.
What do you want to learn then?
Well,
how to knit.
Trying to get on this knitting film.
You know what's funny? I've gotten to work with a lot of different people, but one of the things I've had a limited experience doing, and it's usually like my favorite thing, is when you're on a show and one of the actors gets to direct an episode. And that is like, personally, like, it's the best. Like when you're working with an actor and then the actor who you've worked with and you're maybe doing scenes with is directing their like first stuff, like that's the coolest to me. Just because I approach filmmaking in the same way as an actor. And I think actors just tend to be a little different in what they're asking of you up there. So kind of, you know, just like an actor director. Like you know, like a Clint Eastwood or something like that.
Yes. Chris, did you answer? Director Morley. Chris, is there a dream writer or director out there for you?
Yeah, I think Atlanta is the best show on TV, hands down. So yeah, like Hiro Murai, director, Glover, writer, actor, or directing, dude, he's phenomenal at everything he does. So yeah, that'd be cool.
Thank you. Well, thank you for your questions.
Thank you, guys.